Welcome, football fans. I'm the football guy, and this is my video series where we focus on one random NFL team of the past. If you've ever followed a particular NFL team or player, or even just watched an NFL game, this is the place for you. Okay, I wanted to take a minute to introduce my first giveaway, the Hall of Fame giveaway. In honor of the kickoff to the season, which is the Hall of Fame game for me on August 3rd, I'll be doing my first giveaway with a potential worth of up to $300. The drawing will be held on August 3rd at the end of our Throwback Thursday episode that airs at 7 p.m. The winner will receive 6 Hall of Fame player cards, as well as 6 more Hall of Fame prospect player cards, players who might make the Hall of Fame once they're eligible. Now, you might be asking, what do I need to do in order to qualify for the drawing? And here it is. Number one, you need to publicly subscribe to my channel. That's easy enough. Just click the subscribe button right here. Number two, like each of the 5 videos that will be scheduled between now and August 3rd as outlined. July 20th, we have Throwback Thursday, which is today's episode. July 22nd, Breaking Wax, which is tomorrow's episode. July 25th, next Tuesday, we have the Top 10 Project. July 27th is our next week's Throwback Thursday. And July 28th is next week's Breaking Wax video. And number three, lastly, post 5 different hashtags in the comments section for the 5 videos I listed above. The hashtags will be revealed at some point throughout each of the 5 videos, so you'll need to watch each video to find out which hashtag you should post in the comments. Each video will have a different hashtag. I'll post the giveaway instructions in the description as well as in a community post. Now let's get into this week's Throwback Thursday, and don't forget, look for the hashtag topic in the video. Okay, I've got a big blue button here that says engage on it, and I'm going to push it right now to get it started. And when it's done, it will display the team logo and the team year and name that we're going to focus on. Now the computer is running through thousands of calculations as it searches for the perfect team for us to focus on this week. So check the description down below for a list of all the previous episodes and teams that we've covered so far. And it looks like this week's focus team will be the 2010 Cleveland Browns. Today's episode will take us back to the year 2010 in C-Town, a blue-collar town with a football-crazy fan base, Cleveland, Ohio. Alright, so let me set the stage. The year is 2010. Taylor Swift was all the rage as she won 4 Grammys, including Album of the Year. You are the best thing that's ever been mine. She was selling out arenas all across the country. The pop group One Direction debuted on X Factor. The third place winners went on to become a worldwide sensation, selling 70 million records worldwide. Katy Perry released her Teenage Dream album, which was an instant success, selling 192,000 copies within the first week. Teenage Dream became the second ever album to produce 5 number one singles. By 2010, Kesha's TikTok had become the best-selling single worldwide. It also broke the record for the biggest single week sum of all time for a female artist, selling 610,000 digital downloads in 1 week. Rapper Eminem created and released Love the Way You Lie, featuring Rihanna's powerful vocals for the song.
Well, that's all right. Cause I love the way you lie. I love the way you lie.
Critics described the song as among the best tracks of 2010 in Eminem's career. The Fox TV series Glee was aired for the first time. It was not only based on music, but humor and high school drama as well, and was a big hit as television audiences had never experienced music-based series. 5 paintings of Pablo Picasso were stolen, and the total worth of the paintings was estimated at around 100 million euros. Described as the biggest heist of history, it made highlights around the world and caught the investigators totally off guard. The Twilight Saga, Eclipse, based on Stephanie Meyer's books, was released. It was the 3rd edition in the series and crushed all other movies coming out at the time. It sold $43 million worth of DVDs and racked up $300 million in total sales. Toy Story 3 was released and follows the adventures of Woody, Buzz, and the other toys yet again as they're finally thrown away. The film touched many as it dealt with the reality of life and growing up. Social Network was released, and the film was about how Facebook started in Harvard's dorm room by Mark Zuckerberg, who was accused of stealing the idea. Not only was the movie a big hit, but it also became a strong contender for the Oscars. October 2010 brought us Instagram, the social media app that became an instant hit, a platform where posts need to be accompanied by photos may have seemed odd to many at first, but the idea caught on quickly, and today, Instagram may even be considered part of our culture. With more than 1 billion registered users, it is now the second most downloaded free app on the App Store. 2010 also saw the release of Angry Birds, which spread like fire. At the time, no app was bigger. It was a game developed by a Finnish company that was based on a couple of Angry Birds taking revenge on an evil pig. WikiLeaks took the world by storm. It consisted of classified and top-secret documents regarding toxic waste dumping in Africa, extrajudicial killings in both Guantanamo Bay and Kenya. In July, more than 90,000 documents were released. All that pointed towards the U.S., and then in October, the website released over 40,000 documents pertaining to the American operations in Iraq. The San Jose mine in Chile collapsed in August of 2010, trapping 33 miners 2,300 feet below ground level. After surviving for a record 69 days, the miners were extracted one by one in what was deemed a miraculous rescue. And in the world of sports, the 2010 Winter Olympics took place in Vancouver, featuring sports from alpine skiing to Scottish curling. The U.S. won most number of medals, while Canada grabbed the most number of gold medals overall. Okay, the 2010 World Series was a best-of-seven playoff between the American League champion Texas Rangers and the National League champion San Francisco Giants. The Giants won the series 4-1 to secure their first World Series championship since 1954, and their first since relocating to San Francisco from New York City in 1958. The 2010 Stanley Cup Finals pitted the Chicago Blackhawks against the Philadelphia Flyers. Chicago defeated Philadelphia 4-2 to win their fourth Stanley Cup in franchise history and their first since 1961, ending the longest active Stanley Cup drought. One of the most exciting and watched sports events, the FIFA World Cup, was held in 2010. Countries such as Brazil, Argentina, and South Africa, as well as others, took part in the event, which lasted over a month. It marked Spain's first World Cup victory, making them the eighth nation to win the tournament. Okay, let's get into it. The team, 12 years back in the league after Art Modell moved them to Baltimore, turned to their fourth head coach over that period, named Eric Mangini, in order to right the ship. 2010 would mark Mangini's second year in Cleveland. His team went 5-11 in 2009, and he was looking to take the next step in his second year. The Browns would move on from Brady Quinn in 2009 to Colt McCoy and Jake Delhomme in 2010. They also brought in running back Peyton Hillis from Denver to help bolster the running game. Mangini, however, would prove unable to turn around the franchise's fortune as he went a combined 10-22 over 2 years before the organization would turn to Pat Shurmur as his replacement. The passing game for the Browns ranked 29th overall in passing yards. The QB spot became a revolving carousel with veterans Jake Delhomme and Seneca Wallace and rookie Colt McCoy. Delhomme started the season as QB1 in Game 1 and suffered an ankle injury. Wallace started Games 2 through 5, but an injury to Wallace forced the Browns to turn to McCoy for Games 6 through 11. Delhomme came back for Games 12, 13, and 14, but after being eliminated from the playoffs in Week 14, Mangini started McCoy the last two games. McCoy led the team with 1,576 yards, 6 touchdowns, and 9 interceptions, followed by Delhomme with 872 yards, 2 touchdowns, and 7 interceptions. Wallace was third on the team with 694 yards, 4 touchdowns, and 2 interceptions. The running game, despite a breakout season from Peyton Hillis, still placed near the bottom third of the NFL as they were ranked 20th overall for rushing yards. Peyton Hillis led the team in rushing and was solid throughout the year, posting 1,177 yards, 11 touchdowns, and a 4.4 yards per carry average, as well as playing a significant role in the passing game. Colt McCoy was the second leading rusher on the team with 136 yards, while Jerome Harrison claimed the number 3 spot with 91 yards. And Ben Watson would be the team's leading receiver, pulling in 68 passes for 763 yards and scoring 3 touchdowns. Second-year player Muhammad Masakwai ranks second on the team with 483 yards and two touchdowns. And Peyton Hillis, like we talked about before, would be the number three leading receiver on the team with 477 yards and two touchdowns. The Browns' defense was mediocre at best, ranking 18th overall in passing yards and 27th overall in rushing yards allowed. Linebacker Marcus Bernard provided the pass rush and sacked opposing quarterbacks 7.5 times. The secondary was bolstered by two rookie players. Strong safety TJ Ward topped the team in tackles with 123, and rookie cornerback Joe Hayden proved to be the team's ball hawk with 6 interceptions for 101 return yards. The Browns, continuing to struggle their way back to relevance, added some key pieces through the draft that played prominent roles for the team in 2010. Cornerback Joe Hayden was selected in the first round with the number 7 pick. He would play 12 years in the league, his first 7 in Cleveland, and was an immediate starter. Safety TJ Ward was selected in the second round and would play 8 years in the league, his first 4 in Cleveland. He too was an immediate starter. Quarterback Colt McCoy was selected in the third round and is still playing in the league after 12 years. Aside from starting 21 games for the Browns from 2010 to 2011, he has been a career backup. The 2010 Cleveland Browns season was a challenging one for the team. They struggled to find consistency and ended the season with a disappointing overall record of 5-11. Offensively, the team faced difficulties as they cycled through multiple quarterbacks due to injuries and inconsistent performances. Running back Peyton Hillis emerged as a bright spot for the Browns with a breakout season, rushing for over 1,100 yards and scoring 11 touchdowns. On the defensive side of the ball, the Browns had some solid individual performances, but as a whole, the unit struggled to contain opponents. Despite the team's struggles, there were a few notable highlights throughout the season. In Week 7, the Browns secured a memorable victory against the New Orleans Saints, who were the defending Super Bowl champions. It was a hard-fought game that showcased the team's potential. Thanks for joining me on this week's Time Machine Trip Back to 2010. Let me know in the comments what your favorite memory of this team was, or if I missed anything. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and tell a friend. As always, stay safe, and I'll see you next time.